Okay, good. So, Cut Lawn is a Hanoi-based hardcore band that has been around for years. They perform an amazing, satisfying, big-time live show where they dress up like Pikachu from Pokemon. They are quite successful and make great videos on YouTube, and they have a loyal following. They are starting to collaborate with other big bands in Vietnam, play outside the country, and generally kick ass. How true was that, Quang?
Like, we are not that big, you know. We just really want to have fun and like play as many shows as possible, having more friends, and like hanging out at the shows, moshing, like playing like with the music and stuff.
Yeah, you guys are very fun, and you guys have tons of friends, it seems like, and you guys like to party and have a good time. Yeah, and it's fucking great, and you guys make great music videos.
Yeah, this part of the fun.
yeah, super fun. Who is the music video guy? Is it you or someone else in the band?
Yeah,
or
like most like all the all our videos are DIY. So like it's the all the bands like we come up with a script.
Yeah.
And then we ask friends around if they want to join the video.
Yeah.
And like and then we just like have a camera and shoot it.
Very cool. You guys film your videos in like one day or 2 days or something?
Yeah, like mostly we shoot it in one day. Maybe in some like different location. Yeah, but like so that like all the friends can be there for one day and then we shoot the whole thing.
Yeah.
And then we edit it.
Yeah. And do you have any music videos coming up or any stuff coming up?
Yeah, we have quite a few more songs.
Really?
Plan to have we plan to have our second album ready soon.
Right. You guys released your first album, which is Zwa Ka? No, what is the, how do you say that? Zao Ke.
Zao Ke.
Okay.
Yeah.
That is your first album. What does that mean,
Zao Ke? Zao Ke is, Good Lord Zao Ke is a slang for Good Lord Zao Ke. Good Lord is basically mean the balu, you know, balut, the delicacy. And then Zao Ke, Zao Me is like stir fry with the tamarind.
Okay.
So, we say it's a slang for.
Good luck.
Stir fry balut with the tamarind.
Oh, okay. It's a dish.
Yeah.
Okay. Very cool. Funky dish.
Yeah. Funky dish. Quite exotic.
And what does your name mean? What does Cut Lawn mean? Huh?
Yeah. Good Lawn means basically it means balut, the dish.
But no, like but with, Cut Lawn. What does your band name?
Yeah, Cut Lawn. It means balut.
Oh. Yeah. So it doesn't mean
the dish quail egg.
Okay.
Also like, but like without all the accent, Vietnamese accent.
Yeah.
It can also means like pig shit or like shit cunts.
Right. Oh, okay.
Yeah, like it's just the play of upwards and.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
I thought it meant shit c word, like shit pussy or whatever.
Yeah.
Dual meaning. Okay.
Yeah. Dual meaning.
Okay, that's cool. Cool. I was wondering about that. And so, okay, let's get your plugs out of the way. And so you guys have, okay, what is Skewers Records? Is that you guys or is that your friends? You guys are a part of Skewers Records, and it seems like that's a little recording studio that you guys do your recording at.
Yeah. Like we do everything ourselves. So Skewer Record is also just a studio thing that we
that is you guys
put it on. Yeah, it's basically us.
Very cool. And you guys have some bands you're working with there.
Yeah, like we help our friends to come and record, like mostly metal bands, also some indie bands.
Right.
Mostly and via friends.
There's one girl you have there, the Meow something or something?
Yeah, we just finished recording some drums and some vocal for Meow Lab.
Meow Lan.
Yeah, pop punk indie band from Hanoi. Yeah.
Very cool. Yeah, there is starting to be a scene, eh? Or I guess there probably has been for a long time and I'm just learning about it.
Yeah, but also they're quite new. I mean, they,
yeah,
I think for a year.
There is a lot of new stuff. How long have you guys been around?
I don't remember. I think from 1918.
No, wow.
I don't know. That's no, shit. Oh, 2018. From 2018, so 3 years.
2018. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, very cool. Yeah. And so, and then you guys have your YouTube page, Cut Lawn YouTube page, C-U-T-L-O-N. So everyone should like and subscribe and follow and comment and listen and all of that shit, right?
Thanks.
Yeah. Yeah, because you guys make fucking amazing music videos and you guys have an amazing live performance and you guys are super fun, fun vibe.
Thank you. Thank you.
Yeah. So you guys kind of have it all. And so, okay. And then you guys make music videos. Like, how many views do you guys have? Like 70,000, not 10,000 more?
Like, it really depends on like videos. Some got like a few thousands. But like, I think we had a song that we featured the Seven Uppercuts.
Right.
And I think that, I think that video got like 20,000 or something.
20,000?
Yeah.
That's very cool. Yeah, Seven Uppercuts. You guys did a collaboration with Seven Uppercuts, and we are going to play that later.
Cool.
Okay, and then I talked about your album, Xiao K?
Xiao K.
Xiao K. Okay.
Yeah, Xiao K.
Okay. And then also you guys make amazing t-shirts. And so how do you buy your t-shirts? You usually sell them after the show or what?
We just like print, we just like design it ourselves.
Yeah.
Design the blank shirts and then we have them printed.
Yeah.
And like normally we have them sold at the shows and so at some like shops and stuff.
Okay. So what shops are you guys selling those at now?
You can buy it at the Bui store. I will send you the link later.
Okay.
They're quite cool. It's like a rock shop and you can buy lots of like rock records, rock t-shirt and stuff there.
Right. Okay. Sounds cool. Yeah, I might have been to that. I don't know. Okay. And so, you guys have your own fucking beer.
Yeah.
That's so fucking cool. You guys have a Cut Lawn beer with an amazing cool label on it with your logo, with the drippy, slimy logo thing.
Uh-huh.
And so you guys still have that? They're still selling that or what?
I mean, like, we were still selling it, like, before the COVID.
Right.
But when it hits, like, everything stopped. Also, the factory stopped.
Oh, okay.
So, like, now we are, like, we stopped making it. But when things get back to normal, we just keep selling it.
Right. Who are you guys making that with again?
It's the friend that has it's called the Northern Soul. Northern Soul Brewery. So he also has a bar at the... at the Dahe Street, and he also plays in a hardcore punk band back in Canada. He's Vietnamese. Good friend of ours.
Where did what was he, a Toronto guy or a Vancouver guy, or do you know?
I don't remember. I think a Vancouver guy. Sorry, if I mistake it. I think
hey, no problem. Vancouver has a pretty cool hardcore scene. Yeah, they SNFU and stuff like that. Yeah, very cool. You know the band SNFU? No.
SNF? No.
Okay. Yeah, that's cool. They were cool. They were a long time ago for a band. Yeah, like that's when I was a kid. Yeah. Okay, and so, and then your guitarist released COVID awareness posters, or that was you, or?
Yeah, that was me.
You made COVID awareness posters. You made three different posters and for COVID awareness, you know, positive mental state and things like that.
Yeah, like it was a part of a how can I say, a movement.
Yeah.
Where like people try to, like graphic designers, they try to like raising COVID awareness.
Okay.
So like, so like designers all around the world, they just like made some positive poster.
Yeah.
Put them on together. So I find it quite meaningful and quite interesting. So I just enjoy it. Yeah.
Yeah.
Thank you.
And that one with the gate is very Hanoi, right? The one.
Yeah.
That
yeah,
is super Hanoi.
I tried to put like some like locals like things into them.
Yeah. Very cool. Okay, and so okay, let's play the first song and then we'll come back to